सीइंग आवर अबिलिटीज स्पिरिचुअली एट थ्री प्रोग्रेसिवली डीपर लेवल्स. वी ऑल हैव सर्टन अबिलिटीज विच वी यूजुअली थिंक बिलोंग टू अस. हाउएवर समटाइम्स दीज abilities mysteriously and frustratingly desert us, as when a star sports player hits a low patch, a lean patch, or a award-winning writer meets a writer's block. When our abilities thus seem to desert us, we can either beat ourselves up for our incompetence and become disheartened, or we can introspect using Gita wisdom and learn to see our abilities spiritually. If we choose the latter, then the Gita stands ready to guide our vision at three progressively deeper levels. Level one, we see our abilities as gifts. The Bhagavad Gita 7:8 states that it is the divine who manifests through the human as ability. Paurusham drishu. This means that we are the channels for our abilities, not their sources. If we consider ability to be like a river flowing, then sometimes the river is filled with water and sometimes it isn't. So when ability manifests through us, when we are equipped with this spiritual vision, and we are grateful when ability manifests through us, and if ability doesn't manifest, we accept that gracefully. And as pointers to their source, the Bhagavad Gita 10:41 states that everything attractive manifests a spark of Krishna's splendor. Yad yad vibhuti matsattvam shri madurjitam evava tattadeva vagachattvam mamatejomsh sambhava. This means that even our abilities are sparks of Krishna's splendor. And when an ability manifests through us, it feels magical. If this magic is just a spark, we can scarcely imagine how magical the whole will be. And we all can access that whole, Krishna, by connecting with him through Bhakti Yoga practice and therein relish sublime joy. Third, our abilities can be means to our source. The Bhagavad Gita urges us and assures us that if we worship the Lord through our work done according to our abilities, then we can attain life's perfection. This implies that our abilities are meant to be used in the world in a mood of service to Krishna. And that is a form of worship. So devotion doesn't just mean internally absorbing ourselves in our Lord, but it also means externally contributing on behalf of our Lord. When we thus use our abilities to serve Krishna, then that comprises the ultimate and best use of our abilities, for such use takes us closer to the Lord and helps create resources and products and art pieces that help others also to come closer to the Lord. So to summarize, we can see our abilities spiritually at progressively deeper levels as gifts, as pointers to the divine, and as means to the divine. Gifts from the divine, pointers to the divine, and means to the divine. Thank you.